Alrighty. Well, hello there. We finally have a sky to see up here. It's been weeks on end of crappy weather and a blanket of clouds up above us, so it's really nice to have a clearing here. And tonight we're trying out some new gear. We have the Canon EOS R full-frame mirrorless camera, and the new bad boy is the Canon 100-400mm lens, along with the Canon 2x extender. So at the moment we're at 200mm, and it's going to be all in manual, so let me get situated and I'll get the focus in. Okay, there we are. We're at 800mm, and on the Canon R camera, when you do 4K, it's a crop of 1.75x. And we can go in even further by using the focusing of the 10x. Okay, there we go. We're at our Mesa and light beam area. It's not coming in quite as well as I'd hoped. And I'm sorry, I can't get this overlay information off the screen. It's not possible. So, I'm stuck with it. But when we go in, we can do a crop zoom in Final Cut Pro and see how well it comes out. Now, it's funny, when I did the testing in the house, it seemed to come out pretty well, but by filming the moon, it doesn't look near as good as I thought it would. Drat. All right, that's enough of the big guy. And if I didn't say it, the moon's 55% lit. All right, now we're gonna try to go over to Venus. I hope the alignment is right, because it's really difficult to find a speck of light when the field of view is so small. Oh, and looky at that pretty sight. We have Venus right below the Pleiades. That's such an incredible constellation to see. It looks like a tiny wee dipper. I sure wish I could see them by eye, but all I can see is the moon and Venus. Anyway, whoa! There was something streaking by Venus. That was awful fast. Maybe it was a satellite, but I don't think it'd go that fast. Anyway, who knows? But we're gonna try to get Venus in as a phase. Whoa, and there she is. And it looks like we have a, I don't know, about a 30-some percent crescent of Venus over there. That's quite cool. And I'll try to do a crop zoom. It's very difficult to manually focus. But I'm hoping we have it. I'll get a clip though. I'll be right back. All right, we got a clip of Venus, and I'll try to do an alignment and stacking and the Lens app for Mac. See if it comes out. Hope so. Okay, it's still overexposed after taking the filter off, but we can definitely see the crescent of good old Venus. Cool. And back to the Pleiades. super cool. Now, and I'm not sure, but that might be Sirius. It's so hard to tell. There's a flashing to the 2 o'clock position. I sure hope this picks it up. That's interesting. Kind of looks like Morse code. And it seems to be moving. Boy, I sure hope this picks it up. Just flashing in and out there. And it's a red-orange color. Looks like two of them. Side by side. We'll definitely do a crop zoom. All right, I'll let this play out a bit. It's a bit nippy out here. It's not, it's above freezing, so it's about 40 degrees or so. Fahrenheit. And slowly but surely it's moving away from Sirius. As it heads up in that right angle. What in the world that is? That's got me flummoxed. Wouldn't be a satellite. We know what those look like. Definitely not an airplane. Not zoomed in this far. So we have this one to check out and the thing that zipped by Venus, but that was so quick. I don't know. It's just a quick flash. I'll probably do a fast forward, but I still want to catch this flashing lights there. And we are on the Sky Tracker mount. We don't have the best of alignments, so that's why Sirius is drifting. I mean, those lights are just doing odd flashes. They're flashing at intervals that are not consistent, if you know what I mean. Maybe somebody up there is waving hello to our lockdown planet. It's bonkers down here. So our prison planet's gonna wave goodbye to that red blinker way up there. That is just so cool. But wherever you are in this lockdown planet, hope you're safe and having a good old time. Have all the goods you need and you getting along with everybody? And I hope you're all doing your own research, and the only advice I can give is to use common sense and think for yourself. Don't just trust mainstream media or governments or whoever, especially if it's a government. check into it yourselves. And that's going to do it on this first day of April 2020. 8:56 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. All right. Bye now.